Remember when Elon Musk launched a roadster into space several years ago? Well, it turns out the Tesla and SpaceX CEO is not the only automaker interested in the stars. And while they're not launching any cars into space, the Porsche family and Japanese car makers Toyota and Honda are some of the automakers investing in space technology.
And speaking of the sky, we are exploring rockets too. Because the future of mobility shouldn't be limited to just Earth.
The fact that car companies are investing in rocket ventures is a little bit of a head-scratcher, at first glance at least. I think the primary reason they're doing it is that it allows them to see frontier technologies in application and take those learnings and put them into their core products.
In January, Toyota, through its mobility software subsidiary, announced that it was investing $44 million into Japanese rocket maker Interstellar Technologies. Interstellar Technologies, which was founded in 2013 and has raised around $200 million from private funds and government subsidies, is focused on building rockets to launch satellites into space.
Automotive industries, you need maps from space. Then those connectivities all coming from our satellites. So that is the reason why we need to develop this launch vehicle. In Japan, cadence is really limited. So someone needs to have that kind of connectivities to space. That is our company's goal.
Japan is playing catch up when it comes to launch capacity. In 2024, Japan launched just 7 orbital rockets, compared to the 145 rockets launched by the US and 68 launched by China. Experts say automakers may be able to help and get some benefits in return.
Toyota has obviously a great deal of expertise in assembly lines and improving efficiencies in manufacturing. And this is exactly the kind of thing that space companies and launch companies in particular want to gain access to. They want to be able to produce those launch vehicles as efficiently and as cheaply as possible, because that's how they're going to gain market share.
Interstellar Technologies says it's been working with Toyota since 2020, with the automaker even sending some of its engineers to aid the startup.
We have been collaborating with Toyota in terms of production and also propulsion system. Those engineers really helped to develop Interstellar's propulsion system.
Toyota's venture capital arm, Toyota Ventures, was also an early investor in California-based startup Zona Space Systems, which aims to build a more precise satellite navigation system as an alternative to government-run satellite systems like the United States Global Positioning System, or GPS.
What are those satellites going to be used for, and what are they already being used for? Some of it is for improving navigation services for cars. Some of it's for mapping. If you think about what's going to be needed a little further down the road for autonomous vehicles, having full awareness of what's going on the road is incredibly valuable.
Meanwhile, Japanese automaker Honda's been working on developing a proprietary reusable rocket since 2019 to launch low Earth orbit satellites. The company said its aim was to incorporate its core technologies, including combustion engines and vehicle guidance, into the rocket's development. Honda declined CNBC's request for an interview, but in an emailed statement, the company said it plans to conduct a test of the rocket soon. Holding company Porsche SE, whose long-term core investments include German automakers Porsche and Volkswagen, have also invested in Munich-based rocket company Isar Aerospace. When the investment was announced in 2021, a member of Porsche SE's executive board wrote, "Access to space will be a key enabler for innovations in traditional industries, as well as for new and disruptive technologies and business models." Porsche SE also declined CNBC's request for an interview, and Toyota did not respond in time for publication. One big reason for all this investment in space? Cars are becoming more and more connected, and automakers need the infrastructure to make that possible, satellites and the rockets needed to launch them. One recent report estimates that by 2030, connected vehicles could be a $742 billion per year revenue opportunity for automakers and suppliers. Today, cars use satellite connectivity for tracking and location, software updates, and entertainment like satellite radio.
In the smartphone world, Apple is shifting from a single device sale to additional services that can be provided throughout the life of that device. So for a car, it's the same deal. Once you sell that car, are there additional revenue streams that you can get by providing services? Some of those services can be delivered from space.
One such service is subscriptions to advanced driver assistance systems. Take General Motors Super Cruise, which uses cameras, sensors, and real-time location and map data from GPS satellites to allow the vehicle to do things like automatically steer and keep the car centered in a lane.
Our customer-focused strategy with Super Cruise is to continuously refine and expand its capabilities to make it indispensable. This is how we are setting the stage for recurring high-margin revenue streams from subscriptions. Within 5 years, we expect to approach about $2 billion in total annual revenue from Super Cruise.
Other car makers, including Mercedes, Toyota, and Ford, have similar connected driver assistance systems. Meanwhile, Chinese automaker and Tesla competitor Geely Holding Group has invested $326 million to manufacture its own satellites to support the buildout of its autonomous vehicles.
For car companies on the autonomous driving side, sometimes the precision that they need for that is even higher than what is available from the government-run constellation. So there are some space companies that provide what are called enhanced positioning and navigation services. And so this is another area that the car companies could simply invest in themselves so that they can make the claim that their autonomous driving is 10% safer or 15% more efficient or whatever they want to say, and that is their competitive edge.
Access to satellites can also allow drivers to remain connected to the internet in places where cellular services are unavailable.
If you can have that connectivity no matter where you are, as long as you have a clear view of the sky, then that is potentially a valuable service.
Quincy Edmund Lee has seen the benefits that come from aerospace and automotive collaboration firsthand. Before founding his EV charging company, Electric Era, in 2020, Lee spent a number of years at SpaceX, working on the company's Crew Dragon, Falcon 9, and Starlink satellite projects.
In 2016, I went and toured the Tesla factory in Fremont. We had a number of cross collaborations around taking those production best practices and imbuing them into SpaceX. And then occasionally throughout the years as well for battery programs or solar programs, Tesla and SpaceX would intermediate and, you know, talk about things like degradation curves for battery cell chemistries that we use on the Starlink satellite or the cell technologies that are used on the solar array for the satellite.
In fact, SEC filings show that SpaceX paid Tesla around $5 million in 2020 for various services, car parts, energy products, and software.
In some cases, it goes the other direction, that the space companies have figured out a process for doing something that then can be scaled up into large-scale manufacturing.
An example of a technology that's been adopted from the aerospace industry to the automotive industry is 3D printing, also known as additive manufacturing. In the automotive world, Porsche has used 3D printing to make spare parts for its classic cars, as well as pistons and car seats for its current cars. Another technology crossover, LiDAR.
When you look at the technology that is needed for landing spacecraft on the moon, on Mars, there's a system called LiDAR that uses lasers to detect how close an object is and how rapidly you're approaching that object. And so we've seen some of that LiDAR technology being transferred from the space industry into the vehicles themselves so that they can be more aware of their surroundings and generally be safer as autonomous vehicles.
Lee says EV charging infrastructure could also benefit from space technology.
One of the ways that we're looking to improve our charging stations is actually adding Starlink to every one of our charging stations, basically to get better data, uplink and downlink data access. We'll have some of our charging stations only being able to get 10 kilobytes of data, and that makes troubleshooting or pushing over the air updates more challenging. So adding a Starlink terminal completely solves that problem.
Aside from sharing manufacturing know-how and mutual technologies, automotive and space companies can also share personnel, something that Tesla and SpaceX have been known to do.
At our company, Electric Era, we have approximately 6 engineers that have gone from Starlink to Electric Era, mainly in the design and production space.
Still, experts point out that while investing millions into space ventures may seem like a lot, it's a drop in the bucket for large car makers. But the investment could be just the start to a growing trend.
The amounts that automakers are investing in space companies are still very small by automotive standards. So the investments are being made primarily for strategic reasons. If the automakers are really looking to the future and thinking about what will be possible and what they can have a hand in creating, then space is a natural domain for them to explore.